Asgard. Not by kings, they love spiritual fervor. Blast those to shoot the persecuted man. Retaliation meets a losing first. The best is for his end to lay. Then magic makes the skin off his way. He knows I call my enemy. In his eye, the burning coals on his head. The end. Murder. The end. Let's go forward. The end. Murder. The end. Let's go forward. Thank you.
Freedom! What more can I do? I'm up of a suffering. Blinded eyes to search for no one. Why do I forget my so many ways? Why do I remain so different? My brows are tempting me. In the frozen the virgin seems to go away. They see another way. Blind the eye to no one. I'm sorry.
You can't take it from me.
You can't take my freedom from me.
You can't take it from me.
You can't take my freedom from me.
You can't take it from me.
You can't take my freedom from me.
You can't take it from me.
You can't take it from me.
You can't take my freedom from me.
You can't take it from me.
You can't take my freedom from me.
This could scare you. Dear Art Bell, I just recently began listening to your radio show and could not believe it when you talked about the sounds from hell tonight. My uncle had told me this story a couple of years ago, and I didn't believe him, like one of your listeners who discounted the story as nothing more than just a religious newspaper fabricated account. The story about the digging of the hole and the hearing of the sounds from hell is very real. It did occur in Siberia. My uncle collected videos and audio tapes and so forth on the paranormal, supernatural. He passed away fairly recently, but he would have loved your show. He let me listen to one of the audio tapes that he had on the sounds from hell in Siberia, and I copied it. He received his copy from a friend who worked at the BBC. It took me a while to find it tonight, but attached is that sound from my uncle's tapes. It's not the greatest quality, but the sounds are there. I was very hesitant to send you this, as the sound bothers me to listen to. I'd suggest that if you do play it on the program, warn listeners in advance so they may have the option of turning the radio off for 30 seconds while it plays. It has always haunted me. To those who discounted the Siberia sounds from hell story, it is true, and I, for one, wish it wasn't. Rick, listening from Chicago. And so I submit now the cleaned, a better copy to you, and I warn you, what you are about to hear is very disturbing indeed. That's it. I'll let you come to your own conclusions, as I usually do.